The committee's deputy chairperson, Achen Dorcas, presented the report during plenary sitting today on the status of refugees and refugee hosting communities in Uganda, recommending that the government revises its refugee policy to limit the influx of refugees in the country.
The huge inflow of refugees amidst decreasing donor support, Uganda can hardly cope with this trend.
The committee indicated that this will forestall a probable long-term conflict resulting from overflow of refugees and underfunding resulting from cuts in budgetary support from donors.
All its hospitality has, under difficult circumstances, handled the large inflow of refugees from the Great Lakes region. This has placed a lot of pressure on social services, especially in host communities in the country. Currently, in the health sector, there's approximately one doctor to every 24,000 citizens and one nurse per 11,000 people.
Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, however, said that the report had many loopholes, stating that the recommended policy review should be handled at cabinet level.
It will be left to the executive after wide consultation with the international community, because it's our obligation.
The Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, John Mulimba, said the recommendation on curtailing refugees from entering Uganda is in discord with national and international conventions on refugees, which Uganda ratified.
A bit sad when we're discussing this as if we don't know, and yet this is a Kampala declaration. I would like to plead with colleagues and members that yes, we register the concerns, and most of the concerns are indeed internal administrative issues. If you please, Mr. Speaker, you would guide that this report be referred. We'll refine it and then come back and discuss from a smart point of view.
The Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, said that the Global Summit on Refugees in December 2023 resolved on how to manage the dwindling resources to refugee hosting districts in Uganda, and that therefore the issue should not be used to justify curtailing of refugee entry to Uganda.
Come to Uganda here as refugees. They come to save their dear life. They are running away from problems to our country because we are secure and we are peaceful. And we host them. We have a policy that allows our people or the neighbors to come freely into this country. And almost every month, I get people who come to benchmark on our policies in this country.
Some lawmakers testified that their constituencies have realized progressive development, which is attributed to the presence of refugees there.
Refugees have brought in a lot of development in Terego. If you see the funds coming from Dr. Deep that have built the district headquarters of Terego, is because of refugees.
Countries be exporting refugees and others are importing refugees, and we don't handle it at that diplomatic level where states can discuss to address the causes of refugee export.
The report was referred back to the committee on grounds that it requires a cleanup. Uganda, Africa's largest refugee host, provides refugee to over 1.5 million people. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.